And I thank Dr. Dhananjay Pal because even I would have missed this diagnosis. He rang me up, I was at the OT, that there is an unmarried girl, she's complaining of this short amenorrhea with some amount of bleeding. And should I do a pregnancy test? Is it legal? I mean, can I do it in an unmarried man? I said, of course you can. I mean, get it done. And then he rang me up and told me it's positive. I said, you please admit her. And then in the evening, I called Prashant. At first, I could not make out anything. We have an ultrasound machine in our ward. So I first tried to do the ultrasound. I found the uterus was empty, but I couldn't make out anything further than that. So I called Prashant, who was also in the hospital. So I called him, and both of us saw. And he said, Dilika, you send the patient tomorrow in the morning after good preparation. There's some amount of collection, I feel. So, and the urine test, she told me that it was mixed with blood, so it may be false positive, the girl. But she gave us the history that she had an affair and she had exposure and all that. And she was very cool about it. After that, next day, I think Prashant did the ultrasound, Dr. Lahiri was also there. And there was around 450 ml of collection. And uterine cavity was empty. And again, the urine test was repeated. Rabindex was positive. So we were almost sure that it was ectopic. So it was done that day. It's I think on Thursday it was done.
Next day.
Because she was hemodynamically stable, because this was a tubal abortion.
You are an experienced obstetrician. Ectopics can become a crisis in minutes. How were you so sure that the patient's rupture would not occur? When you were confident and diagnosed it as a rupture ectopic, were you to go for a diagnostic laparoscopy the next day, sir?
Yeah, we could have done it. Retrospective, many things could have been done.
When you lose a patient, you regret. Because if it's a ruptured ectopic, then it's a crisis. And I don't know whether my casualty doctors are here today, because this is invariably missed. Invariably missed.
No, they won't miss. They are very good. They are very good.
Please. Even the Indo doctors, doctors working as power postgraduates in surgery, in medicine, They also miss it. So it is very important for them to have attended this. But unfortunately, I don't know, the inclination was very much lacking.
Actually, the message here is don't take eye pills. I don't recommend people taking eye pills. Since the government of India, I don't know why people are recommending over-the-counter eye pills. Eye pill is the main cause nowadays of not endometriosis, not PID, not this tubal anomalies or malformations. It is the eye pill, which is taken after 12 hours, within that 48 to 72 hours. That is the time when the zygote has formed and is trying to implant. And the motility of the tube is hampered because of progesterone, high progesterone. And it implants in the tube. And that is what is happening, the rate of...
But it is advertised everywhere. There is no side effect you can take.
So people are not aware of this dreaded complication, which can occur very, very
So your gynecological society should take up this issue with the government.
Everything is all through the pregnancy, if you went up to BP and pulse was normal, patient was stable, no muscle guarding, no shock. Actually, second day when I was in the USG, we had some collection about 400 300 ml, but patient was unflinchable. Immediately, patient went and took full food. So I thought
next day she started the surgery.
Full food. Then I thought of doing the beginning. Then I asked parents to bring blood. Then they could not arrange at least blood in shorter 15 minutes.
Regarding unfortunate diagnosis, they could be 400 ml of fluid intra-abdominal.
Few points I'd like, sir, was highlighting clinicals. That's why I'll highlight for some clinicals.